Hey, my name's Jaydee Daley and this is the Fun Food Zone that's all about going out on fun dining out adventures. Today's adventure is watching Aquaman at Vue Cinema, Purley Way. It's based in Valley Park Leisure Complex that has a few restaurants there, so I'll be checking out the restaurants. After the film, I plan to give a very honest review. I have very high expectations because so far I've been so impressed by all the Marvel action films, including the Justice League that Jason was in. He so impressed me in that film. So, I hope you can come along with me. Let's go! I'm heading into Vue Cinema now. I'm in Vue Cinema. I've ordered nachos. I love Vue Cinema nachos.
Permission to come aboard. That was the worst pep talk ever.
Welcome home.
Hey, I'm back. I've watched Aquaman. So the question is, what did I think of Aquaman? I loved it! There was so much action. Action, action, and more action. You know, I love action-packed films. As you know, I've watched all the Marvel action films and all that there is, Pacific Rim, you name it. Sometimes you can get a bit desensitized when it comes to action films when you watch so many of them. But this film had me off the edge of my seat all the way through. It definitely had that sort of new edge to it. It started off with him as a boy, and the storyline of him growing up. But the truth is, I couldn't wait for him to grow up to become a hulking great Aquaman. That's when the film really kicked in, with so many action scenes, so many different characters, creatures, monsters. It had this Pacific Rim scene. I don't know whether you watched Pacific Rim, but based on these big, huge monsters ripping up the city, Aquaman had a scene like that where this huge monster reared out, you know, the type of monster that can blot out the sun. And I thought, yeah! Jason Momoa, he played the role absolutely brilliantly. It definitely seemed like his role. You couldn't imagine anyone else playing that role. And he looks so dynamic and so dangerous. It's almost sort of a relief that he's actually a good guy. Sometimes it's easy to forget that there's a brilliant actor behind these huge roles. You see all the action scenes up like that and you forget that, wow, there's real brilliant acting behind the actual role. The whole cast was great. I love Patrick Wilson as the bad guy. The truth is, he didn't exactly look like a bad guy. He looked like a good guy, a beautiful good guy. Jason looked like the bad guy. You know, the type of bad guy that the first thing you want to do is run. The role was switched. Patrick was the bad guy. And even though he had this lovely exterior, I thought, wow, you know, you naturally think a villain is going to look sort of really evil. But in a way, the fact that he looked so lovely, it sort of made him seem come across even more evil. Also, Nicole Kidman, I loved her in this role. Nicole Kidman played Atlanta, Aquaman's mum. She looked beautiful, very ethereal, elegant. She played the role really brilliantly. It was nice to see Nicole. She looked very young, especially when Aquaman was a grown-up man, and like, she's the mum. I just thought, really? Are you sure that she's not his sister? I was really impressed with Amber Heard. I thought she looked absolutely stunning. She played the role brilliantly. To be totally honest, I thought her career was done for after her rocky divorce from Johnny Depp. So it's really nice to see that she hadn't been ruined. Do you see the dress that she wore at the premiere of Aquaman? Even though I'm straight, I went, doing. She looked absolutely incredible. It looked as though the designer who designed the Aquaman outfit designed her dress, because it looks so out of this world. There was Dolph Lundgren, who played King Neros. He looked so kingly, so dynamic. I've been a fan of Dolph from the get-go, so I was so happy to see him in the role. So well done, Dolph. I'll be looking out for you in your next project. Then there was William Defoe. It was so great to see him in Aquaman, but I was so happy that he played a good guy. I don't know why, I really needed him to be a good guy in this film. So I was just a bit off my seat, is he going to be a good guy? So right until the end, he came through as a good guy. So that really made me, very satisfied for some unknown reason. There was a new kid on the block called Yahya Abdul-Mateen II. I've never seen him before in any other role. He played the Black Manta, was this addition to all Aquaman's adversaries that sort of gave the film that additional edge that I loved. I'm really looking forward to seeing what Yaha comes up with next. It was nice to see a new face at the same time. But overall, the cast was absolutely brilliant. So my overall summary of this film is you have to watch it in the cinema. It's not one of those stay-at-home Sky Cinema or Netflix films. It's definitely a film you have to pick yourself up, go to the cinema, watch it on the big, big screen. All the action, you want to max it out on the big screen. And yes, I hope you've enjoyed watching this vlog. If so, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, please don't forget to subscribe, because I'll be uploading videos of fun food and adventure in and out of London. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.